when you have reports.
All right, folks, we're going to take a short break. We seem to have lost the callers. Hold on just a second.
Yo, yo. Okay. Hey, don't know what happened, guys. I'm sorry. Phone, it just ended again.
There you go, guys. You're back on.
All right.
I'm sorry about that, Dillon.
Ready to rock. Hey, don't sweat it. We're back to the old Cowboys Indians. That's right. But as I was saying, Dallas is actually pretty healthy for this matchup. They're only missing Tavon Austin, and no one's playing Tavon Austin anyways. On Washington's side of the ball, you have Jordan Reed out. You have Darius Geis out. You have AP coming in. All the drama from last week and Peterson being a healthy scratch, and how do the veterans feel about it? So I guess we're definitely going to find out how the veterans feel about it today when they host their division rival Cowboys. You've got Dak Prescott coming off of a stellar performance against the New York Giants. They'll be looking to sling the rock around again. I'm not crazy about Amari Cooper being matched up on Josh Norman, but this is the same Josh Norman who we saw watching DeSean Jackson score two touchdowns.
Well, DeSean's a different beast. He's straight speed. Amari's more efficient route runner, which is more Josh Norman's specialty. He can't handle the speed. He's never been able to.
Well, that's true. That's true as well. And then we didn't really get a good feel for how well the Washington run defense is. I mean, with Philly having to do such a...
Isn't Jonathan Allen still out?
Performance. I believe Jonathan Allen's still out. I think Kerrigan may even be banged up. But my point is, we're not sure exactly how this defense, you know, with all the Bama boys and the new pieces with Landon Collins, is going to perform against Ezekiel Elliott when the Eagles weren't exactly able to get going on the ground last week after trying to rally from behind 17-0. So we'll see. I think Zeke is going to have a big week. There's been all these reports about him. You know, no more training wheels, no more restricting the touches. Tony Pollard, we'll see you later. You know, have fun on the pine. And Zeke's going to be doing the old feed me gesture all day long, first down, touchdown.
I know you love that as an Eagles fan.
Oh, I just love when he does the feed me stuff. It makes me so happy, and I want more of it in my life. If I could have a gift in my profile picture, please, somebody help me out.
Well, just kidding.
What do you think about the fantasy performance today in that matchup?
In Washington, Dallas, you know who my sleeper is? Not against that defense. That secondary is a lot better than the Eagles secondary. I'm not saying Eagles are bad. I'm not saying the best part of that Eagles is the front seven on that defense. I'm not saying the secondary is bad, but Dallas secondary is loaded with defensive talent along that, and I just think Keenum isn't gonna do what he did in Washington. And I think he surprised Philly with some of his throwing ability, and then he disappeared in the second half. So I don't have any faith in Keenum. I think Dallas wins this one by 15.
I also have Dallas winning this one. I'll say this about the secondary is that I don't think Dallas has a more talented secondary than Philly, but I think they may have.
I knew that was coming.
They may have a more disciplined secondary. You know, what was killing the Eagles last week was the play fake and the deep routes after play action. I think after seeing that, Dallas will give the receivers more cushion. They won't bite up on those handoffs to Peterson when they know that guys like Van Der Esch and Jalen Smith can take care of it. So I think the secondary will be more disciplined, and you won't get those big shots from Case Keenum. That being said, as much as I don't like a guy like Terry McLaurin this week, I do like sneaky Vernon Davis to come in and get about, you know, 6-7
the ageless wonder.
80 yards. The ageless wonder who is Vernon Davis.
He hurdled a defender and broke two tackles last week for a touchdown, and I thought he broke a hip with how high he jumped.
Yeah, that was quite a highlight. One of those where you think one of your fellow teammates has the guy and he doesn't, so by the time you go to grab him, it's too late.
He pulled the old rabbit out of the hat.
I don't know about you, but I cannot think of Vernon Davis without thinking about Mike Singletary.
Oh, of course. With him walking off to the locker room. But you know what? I think that changed him. I think Singletary chewed him out so bad, it made him, like, look in the mirror once he got back in that locker room. And it's been a different Vernon Davis the rest of his career.
Yeah, that's true. I didn't expect Vernon to stick around this long, to be honest. They were doing all these reports back in the day about how he liked the art world and he was more interested in other things. I expected him to retire years ago, but here he is with another opportunity to be your great streaming option with Jordan Reed out. If you guys are looking for help in the tight end position and your guy just isn't performing or he's out, go ahead and pick up Vernon Davis. I think he's a good play this week. You and I both have Dallas winning, correct?
Yep. Yeah, I have Dallas by 15, I think. I mean, another underrated weapon for Dallas is Cobb. They used him a lot more than I thought they were going to last week, and I think that they continue to do that. He had a big day, or he has had big days against Washington when he was with Green Bay.
Oh, yeah, Cobb. I do like that, actually. Yeah, so
how
sneaky little play.
You.
If you got a...
What do you mean, how dare you?
We will
I forgot.
Here's the problem. Yeah, and I'm going to jump in here because I heard this. All of a sudden,
oh God,
I'm calling you out, Dave. You can never say anything nice about Cobb because you were always negative when he was a freaking Packer. Now that he is on a team that we're supposed to hate, now all of a sudden you like Cobb? Oh, that's it. I should mute your
I never said
right now.
I like Cobb. I never said I like Cobb. I said he's a good matchup for Washington. He's always been good against Washington in the past for Green Bay. Don't you put words in my mouth.
Blah, blah, blah. Words inserted in mouth along with your foot. Blasphemy.
Not really. I didn't say I liked him. I'm still glad we got rid of him.
And moving on.
Thank you.
No, I can't. I honestly, like, you two need to put up a poll about how many catches and yards you think Top will finish with at the end of the year. We'll let the Twitters vote on that, the first and goalers vote on how they think Top is going to finish at the end of the year, and you two can slug it out that way.
I'll delete the tweet.
Next up on the game slate, we have Indianapolis traveling to Tennessee to take on
good matchup.
Mariota and those Tennessee Titans. Will we see another Derrick Henry 77-yard screen pass down the sideline? Who knows? But I can't wait. Out for Indianapolis, we have Jabal Sheard. That is going to impact the pass rush ever so slightly. But you still have Jamal Houston what is his first name?
Houston. Of who?
Justin Houston. Let's on the other side for Indianapolis, but they're...
Did you have an aneurysm? Are you okay?
I did. I couldn't remember Justin Houston's name for the life of me. Wow.
Good Lord. I want you to get checked out, Dillon. I'm sorry about that.
Too many shots to that, I guess. I don't like this matchup for Tennessee this week because you have Delanie Walker, arguably their best pass catcher out there, and he's going to be going up against the likes of young Darius Leonard, defensive rookie of the year last year. You also have Malik Hooker, a very talented, underrated safety because he always gets banged up for Indianapolis. I think they're going to do a good job bottling up Walker, They're going to make Marcus Mariota pass outside the hashes to guys like Corey Davis and A.J. Brown, who actually had a pretty good week last week coming
balled out
with a 100-yard performance. Yeah. So maybe this is more of an Adam Humphries type of week. We'll see. I know Indy obviously wants to establish the run with Derrick Henry. And then on Indy's offensive side of the ball, I do like T.Y. Hilton after a 2-touchdown performance last week, which I wasn't expecting at all. Against the
what about a Marlon Mack? Does he have another one?
I don't think Marlon Mack is going to have another 174-yard performance, but I wouldn't put it past him to have 100 yards. Obviously, Indy, without Andrew Luck, is trying to focus more on pounding the rock and making reads easier for Jacoby Brissett. So this might be an Eric Ebron type of week, believe it or not, just because I think he'll be a good matchup with guys like Byard and those type of guys covering the deep routes. I think you can hit a lot of underneath stuff, and you'll be able to hit Ebron. Ooh. He might have a touchdown in this game.
I got to jump in here now, Dillon, because all the other places, including NFL Network, have Sidham, and they have Ebron under tight ends as their number two Sidham this week. So this is a counter of what is the national people are saying. So I really want you to get into detail on this one here for the people. All right, Dillon, because this is a good one because it's going against what the big boys are saying. All right? This is a good opportunity, Dillon.
Oh, yeah, clearly where I'm going to make my money. Because, like I said, Tennessee, you've got Adoree Jackson, you've got Kevin Byard. They're going to be focusing on not giving up the big play, making sure that T.Y. Hilton stays contained underneath. You've got Jack Doyle. He's going to be working his routes, and hopefully they use a guy like Mo Alley-Cox a little bit more, their third tight end, because he's a real red zone weapon. If they use three tight end sets, and you've got Jack Doyle, Ebron, and Mo Alley-Cox out there all at the same time, I like Ebron a lot to sort of get lost in the mix, to hit right in the middle of the field. He's got a big body, and that 3-4 defense for Tennessee is I just don't think they're geared up pass-wise to handle a guy like Ebron this week who, you know, with Devin Funchess being out for the rest of the season, I think Jacoby Brissett's going to look for Ebron a lot more, that big body target in the red zone. Does that make sense to you, D, with Funchess being out?
I mean, yeah, it does. I mean, with Funchess being out, it just opens the door for a little bit more. There's some other under wide receivers that can come up and make a play, too, besides those tight ends.
Yeah, I mean, Indy certainly has been ranting about guys like Deion King and Paris Campbell all offseason. So maybe this will be their week to break out and really show the fans what they can do and sell some jerseys in Indy. But I just think, you know, you have a big body guy in there like Funchess, and then you have a smaller speed guy. So you got to get used to those guys playing their roles. Now you have one role player missing. Well, who's going to step up and fill in that role? Is it a small speed guy like Paris Campbell? No. Is it a small speed guy like Deion Kane? No. So you have the big body there at Ebron to step in basically as a wide receiver. I wouldn't be surprised. See, I don't know how you feel about this. If Ebron and Funchess' 40 times were pretty much the same.
Oh, yeah. Funchess is, he's not a speed guy by any means. We know that.
I mean, coming out of the combine, I know Ebron ran in the 4-3 range, and I imagine it's a little slower these days, but I'll bet you line those two up, and Ebron's getting the better of them all day long. So I do. As far as the overall matchup goes, though, as far as to who's going to win this game, you know, it's in Tennessee, but I'm going to take the Red Hot Colts and Jacoby Brissett. How about you, D?
Just for you, Monty, I'm taking the Titans. I think Derrick Henry has himself a day.
All right, folks. Well, we're going to take a quick break, and when we come back, we'll break down the rest of these matchups. Don't go away.
All right, folks, it's about that time, and if you have any other comments, you want to get on Facebook.com, and you want to go to NFL Addictions on Facebook.com for all of your NFL chatter. It is not a trash talk site, but It's one of those places where you can get everything out there. There's lots of people. Keep it clean. Keep it cordial. Go to NFL Addictions on Facebook.com. And if you